Hey, scientist, I was just... Whoa, sorry. I was about to go... Oh, my stomach has been doing that all day. Do you know what's going on, scientist? I'm hungry, but I don't want to eat. I want to... I should probably eat something, huh? We've already learned that animals need food to stay alive, but why? How does food keep me healthy? Let's figure it out by putting together a meal. Food is where we get the nutrients our body needs, and different types of food have different nutrients in them. There are five main food groups, and each one provides the body with some very important nutrients. Let's discover more about the different food groups and how they help the body. As we go, we can add something from each food group to my plate to make a delicious and healthy meal. First, we have a food group called grains. Grains are food that come from specific types of grass-like plants. We get lots of different foods from these plants, like rice, bread, pasta, and cereal. Grains are a great source of carbohydrates, which are the nutrients that give us energy. I'm going to add some rice to my plate and make sure I leave plenty of room for other food groups. Dairy is another food group that provides the body with a specific nutrient called calcium. Calcium is stored inside our bones and is what keeps our bones and teeth strong and healthy. We get dairy products from the milk that animals, like goats and cows, provide. Cow's milk, yogurt, cheese, and even ice cream are a part of the dairy food group and a great source of calcium. Non-dairy alternatives like soy milk, coconut milk, and almond milk contain calcium as well. I'm going to need a drink, so a glass of milk will be a great addition to my meal to give me lots of calcium. Green leafy vegetables are another source of calcium. Vegetables are a food group that comes from plants, and they provide the body with a lot of different nutrients. Did you know sometimes people get fruits and vegetables confused? For example, is an apple a fruit or a vegetable? What about a tomato? They are actually both fruits. Fruits carry the seeds of the plant, so any food that has seeds, whether on the inside, like a pepper, or on the outside, like a strawberry, is technically a fruit. Meanwhile, vegetables come from any other part of the plant, like the roots, stem, or leaves. In terms of nutrients, fruits and vegetables have a lot of similarities. For example, both fruits and vegetables provide the body with fiber. Fiber is what helps food digest once it gets to the stomach. So, a fiber-rich diet helps keep the tummy aches away. Fruits and vegetables also contain vitamins. There are lots of different types of vitamins, and each one does something special for the body. From helping the eyes see better to helping the skin heal faster, the vitamins we get from fruits and vegetables are crucial to keeping us feeling our best. Have you ever tried a spinach and strawberry salad, scientist? It's so yummy! And these fruits and vegetables will give us tons of important vitamins. Let's add it to the plate. Finally, we have a food group called proteins. Proteins can come from animals, like meat and eggs, and also plants, like nuts and beans. These foods provide us with a nutrient called iron, which helps to keep our blood healthy. It also provides us with a nutrient called protein. Pretty easy to remember, huh? Proteins give us protein. The nutrient protein is what our body uses to help our muscles grow after we exercise, which just goes to show that eating well and exercising work together to keep the body feeling its best. My favorite protein is chicken, so I'm going to add a piece of grilled chicken to my meal. Yum! This plate is looking pretty full and pretty delicious. But wait, we haven't talked about candies and sweets. Well, since candy is mainly sugar, it does not fall into any food group. The same goes for fats and oils, like butter and olive oil. These foods are mostly made up of a nutrient called fat. Fat helps to store the body's energy, but a little bit goes a long way, so we call these sometimes foods. If you have too much of them, your body will tell you. A lot of the time, the body will become tired after having a lot of sugars, fats, or oils because it is working extra hard to use up all that extra energy. It's perfectly fine to have these foods sometimes, but it's important to fill your plate with foods from the five main food groups first. I want to make sure I'm not filling my whole plate with these types of foods, but a little bit is okay. I'll drizzle a little bit of olive oil on top of my salad as a dressing. Since our bodies need all of these different nutrients to feel happy and healthy, it's important to have a balanced diet. Having a balanced diet means that every day you eat from each of the five food groups in order to ensure that your body is receiving each of these very important nutrients. Wow, the plate we made is looking balanced. I can't wait to eat this meal and give my body all of these healthy nutrients. Remember how we said that it's important to listen to your body when exercising? Well, it's important to listen to your body when it comes to food too. Your body will tell you how much to eat when your stomach starts to feel full. And it's important to listen to it, or else you could eat too much and get a terrible bellyache. Your body will tell you when you need to eat too. A growling stomach like mine is a key sign that it's time to give your body some more nutrients. Luckily for me, we just created a meal that includes all five food groups. This balanced diet will give me all the nutrients I need to help my stomach stop growling. And now I know that next time I should pay attention to my body and what it's telling me it needs. Thanks for your help today, scientist. I'm going to eat this food and give my body what it needs. I'll see you next time. Until then, remember, science is all around you, and it's part of you too. Hey, hey.